Next up, then, we have full system build.
All right, full system
custom build. Yeah, yeah, custom build, you know, whatever that we saw this year that we think is awesome.
All right, so I'm going to bring it. I have it for show and tell because we still have it. And right, it's actually just, we're going to ship it back this week finally, man. Really, really, I am.
I think this is the one he's been talking about for like a month saying he was shipping it back.
Yeah, no, more than 1 month. I think it's been more than a month.
Like this is the most power you can get in a desktop computer today, period.
It's the size of a toaster.
All right, tell us what it is.
This is the Falcon Northwest Fragbox 2. We used in the video. This thing is just insane. It's, you know, it has the four terabyte SSD in there. It has 64 gigs of RAM. It has two Titan X Pascal cards, a 10-core Broadwell E in this box. Everything you need. That's basically, and as far as, I mean, you don't get any more because you can't run video cards today.
He's trying to sneak that 10-core chip. Yeah,
look, 10-core Broadwell E in here. But look, could you get any more dense with power? Two Titan X Pascal, 64 gigs of RAM, 10-core Broadwell E, 4 terabyte SSD, plus there's also an M.2 drive and NVMe for boot up. That's, an older 950 Pro. 1 terabyte, I think.
It's a beautiful machine that you could run from your cardboard box after you sell your house to afford it.
How's Brad going to run his Vive? He needs this performance. I'm just saying, this is just an incredible... You can't look at this box and go like...
No, I think it's amazing. Right. What's the price on this guy?
I don't even know. It's like $85 million. And it's like about $8,000. So, but I mean, the Titan X Pascals are what, $1,500 or something? $1,300? Yeah. And CPUs, $1,600. I mean, yeah, it all adds up really quickly, but it's incredible to think you can get that much performance in a box this big. Oh, and the chip is overclocked too.
All right. I'm in agreement. I don't have anything better than that.
You made a convincing argument.
Oh my God, 10 core Broadwell E, look.
Snuck in.
I can't find the price.
It's 8 grand.
Real quick. Yeah, it's pretty expensive. But I got to say, the one that I was pretty damn excited to see come in here, I used that for months to do some gaming on, so I do love that one.
Right.
But I got to throw the Origin Omni out there. That was pretty damn cool to see such power in an all-in-one.
Yeah, they should get a shout
pretty
out.
Pretty big.
That was my runner-up was the Omni, Origin Omni. If you want to flash a picture of it up there. It is the first all-in-one that you can actually work on. The thing that kind of still burns me on the Omni, I love curved displays, wide aspect ratio, but the screen quality, the panel quality is...
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
Not great. It's almost a deal breaker. It's not really a deal breaker because you're still getting... I mean, I don't know if you know this, but they built an all-in-one. It has a Titan X. It has that one had a 8-core. So I had a 6900.
I'm sorry, Gordon. I got to stop you real quick because I'm showing the people on the stream the Origin PC website, showing the Omni, and it's got a little carousel with reviewer commenters, and the second slot is with room for a Titan X and 8-core CPU inside. The Omni is truly made for gaming. Gordon Ung, PC
but I
World.
I wouldn't trust that guy. He's an idiot. Well, I mean, that guy's always recommending you buy $1,600 CPUs.
I only trust Gordon. Ma Ung, not his evil brother.
Yeah, Gordon Ung.
But yeah, it's incredible because you can open that baby up, swap the motherboard out, swap the video card out. It's cool. It's the concept is great. I really hope there's a second generation where the panel quality gets significantly better. So
yeah, I mean for me, if I'd love that if the panel was awesome, then I'd probably argue. But because of the panel alone, I'm going to go with the Fragbox as well. So,
and it's got the 10 core. I know that moved you.
Oh, yeah. Man, it moved me real deep.
I don't have an alternative pick, but I will say my favorite system gimmick of this year is that Asus gaming desktop where you would put like a wristband on, and every time you wave it by it, it would like hide a hard drive partition so you could like hide your porn when the boss is working around or wife or whatever's walking around.
Yes.
Taxes.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, they said it was for taxes. Like, yeah, you know what's going to be on that hidden partition.
Well, I got to bring it up. What was it again?
Me? Use something. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Never mind. That
it's a
right
big,
then.
Huge gaming desktop.
Yeah, it's a crazy looking case.
You had a wristband that you'd wear, and you'd swing it by it, and it would unlock a hidden partition.
That's funny. All right. All right. Then, yeah, that was pretty easy. I'll flash up the graphic. 2016's the full nerd.
Gordon's going to get
best
cocky.
System build is the Falcon Northwest Fragbox.
Well, you picked two of them.
So next up is best laptop of 2016. We've had some crazy advancements, and I know Gordon's going to go ahead and come out and say it's the new MacBook Pro with Touch Bar, because it is revolutionary. Hey. So I think we can just go ahead and call it at this point, right?
You can run Doom on that Touch Bar. So
yep, boom, it is done. It's a gamer's machine.
So I had to really think about that. I was kind of torn. The first GTX 1060 laptop I saw was at MSI. In fact, it's right behind us. 4 pounds. It's an awesome. You can get that thing down to $1,500 with a quad Skylake part. GTX 1060, 16 gigs of RAM, 128 gig SSD, and a 1 terabyte hard drive. Man, it's awesome. But the speakers kind of kill me on that. So I was really torn between the MSI, which I love. I think it's a great laptop because it is just so light. You're getting so much gaming performance. But I think what kind of does it, especially compared to that one, which is the 4K version with a larger SSD, it's $2,000. For $2,000, you can also get the Alienware 13. That OLED panel is just like, it's just stunning.
Ah, but that design, I really don't
I really don't like the Alienware design.
Oh, man. And the bezel and it's 13 inches. I'm not going to game on 13
inches. Yeah, but for me, it kind of works because it is a more compact laptop.
I don't mind the 13 inches. I just don't like, I feel like their designs are still very thick for like what I'm looking at in the laptop market these days.
Yeah, but you know,
when I look at like the Blade and the Blade Pro and how thin those things are, as somebody who has to like carry around a gaming laptop all the time,
sure,
the Alienware 13 and that whole line just is like very thick still.
But I mean, the rationale that they make, and actually it does prove out, is that it's quieter, it's thicker.
So absolutely.
You can run higher clocks, you can run the fans lower RPM. So you can either have it really loud and light, or you can have it, you know, more quiet and.
No, I totally agree that is, you know, a feature worth considering. Right. I just feel like most of the time I will take the louder fans if it means that it's a laptop that I want to carry for an entire day and not just like, oh, this thing is so huge and chunky.
I think you usually use headsets while you game anyway.
Yeah,
so
especially on like a laptop. Like if I'm, you know, in a bedroom or whatever, I'm not going to rely on those crappy laptop speakers.
Yeah, no, and it's just the thing is, you got to remember with these thin laptops, the fans are really thin. They're really high RPM. They get
whine.
They're a high whine RPM kind of fan noise, not the low RPM. So,
I mean, to that same degree, then, with the MSI, it's kind of a non-point that the speakers are crappy on it, because you're probably going to use a headset. So
true.
My vote's for the MSI.
The MSI?
Yeah.
I have a left-field pick.
All right, what do you got?
I got a left-field pick. I'm really, really impressed by all the 1060 laptops, because those can run the Vive, too, and that's pretty nuts that you can run VR off a 4-pound laptop these days.
Oh, your $800 VR thing, right?
Yeah. But, and you guys are going to make fun of me, maybe not Gordon, because he's rocking one right now, but for laptops, for most people, I'm all about the Chromebooks, dude.
Oh, man.
I love them.
Yeah, okay.
You never have to worry about the Windows updates going. You have the speed, you have the security, and this year, something came out that I've been begging for years, because for all previous years, you could either get $200 cheap plastic crap or like a $1,500 Pixel. This year, the Dell Chromebook 13 came out. And it's actually like a nice Chromebook that's like $400-$450. It's got a backlit keyboard, a full HD screen, you know, magnesium alloy, carbon fiber. It's like a Chromebook you don't mind using. It comes with all the advantages that Chromebooks have. I love that. Just pick it up and go, and it works. Boom.
So I'm going to go with my own left field pick. And because we're getting into like non-gaming laptops
now. We're fragmented now.
I want to nominate the Blade Stealth because for $1,000, I think that is a real nice ultrabook. And for me personally, beats out the XPS 13.
But no, but it's not a
gaming laptop. But like, you know, I use a gaming laptop because of my job. I find it very hard to recommend gaming laptops to most people because they're, you know, very expensive compared to a comparable desktop. And 2 years after you get them, they're pretty much obsolete. And you're like, well, now I have to buy another crappy gaming laptop. So I think that most people are still buying like, oh, I just need a laptop for like doing, you know, work on the go and stuff like that. I think that Blade Stealth is really good at taking what Razer has done with a Blade and turning it into like a lightweight portable ultrabook version.
It's a nice laptop.
It kind of looks like a MacBook.
I don't think it wins this category, but I do think that is one of the nicer pieces of hardware that I've used this year.
That's very nice. I hear the orchestra playing the music, so that means get the Chromebook and that integrated graphics laptop off the stage. Man, those are great documentaries. Great. That's good stuff.
In that case, I'm voting for the MSI. I just really don't like I like Alienware's internals these days, but I really don't like those designs.
It does have the amplifier port, so yeah. You can run your external graphics.
I just really like those designs in this day and age feel so chunky and like 2011-esque to me.
You're voting MSI.
MSI, yeah.
So I haven't touched either of those, so I'm just going to go with the Guru. Whatever Gordon picks, I pick.
Oh, wait. So that's a tie again.
Well, no, I said MSI. What'd you say? Oh, you wanted the OLED.
I wanted the Alienware OLED. Beautiful, man. OLEDs are just... You got to see an OLED. You want to cry.
I mean, my phone has an OLED screen. It's real nice.
But
you can't nominate it just on the screen alone.
No, but the performance is there. It's a 1060 part. It's a quad core Skylake. It's a little thicker. It's a little heavier. I mean, I will say the MSI.
Not just a little.
If I had to, if I had to carry something, the MSI at 4 pounds, man, you can't. 4 pounds.
Yeah, I think
that's
we should go with the MSI. Yeah.
You sold me, Gordon. MSI it is.
So what's the model, Gordon?
It's the MSI GS63 VR Stealth, which is, I mean, it's a, you know.
I think I spelled stealth right. Yeah, let me.
I mean, if MSI could get there, this really goes for like MSI and ASUS and all of them. If you could come up with like more inspiring model names, that would be like real great. Because,
all right,
like I will say, like that's one of the things that Apple gets right, and then I think Razer gets right. Like if I say like it's the Blade Stealth, you know exactly what that is. Yeah. If I say like it's the MSI VR M73XQ,
I think that's the problem is Apple and Razer have three products.
Yeah,
right. I mean, you go and look at MSI's laptop page or ASUS's laptop page, there's like 15 different SKUs because you've got the same laptops, and because you can have diversity on the PC, you've got everything from 970M to 1060.
Sure. I think that all those can be like subdivisions of like a bigger model. So like, you know, if you had like an MSI, like Red Dragon, and then yeah, you can have the 1060 version, the 1070 version, whatever. Yeah. But like, at least then you know, like this is our line. Like you can recommend that line to somebody, and not like a jumble of model numbers.
Yeah, but I think they build them for all the different, you know, stores that want different SKUs and like so. But you would take this the MSI over a MacBook.
Yeah, I
Pro
just
15,
really value that portability.
Like.
That thing is. Real nice.
All right, then I'll flash up the fancy graphic. The Full Nerds 2016 laptop of the year is the Apple MacBook Pro 15 inch with touch bar. Just kidding. The MSI GS63 VR Stealth takes the cake in that category.